In this video, we'll be looking at the TAF workflow, which is very much centered on R scripts that are run sequentially. They structure the stock assessment into separate steps, and what we'll end up with is clean, organized, and reproducible assessments. So the aim of TAF is to implement a framework to organize data, methods, and results used in ICES assessments, so they are easy to find and rerun later with new data. If you look at the diagram showing the TAF workflow and the different components, it's about going from data to analysis and results. We start with getting data from ICES databases and other data sources. And the first step in the data folder is to gather the data and to filter and pre-process the data that will finally be used in the assessment. So that is one of the major aims of TAF, is to document and script this process of preparing the data, describing where they came from and what was done to them before they were entered in the assessment model. Moving on to the input folder, the task there is to convert the data from the most general format, crosstab year by age usually, into the model-specific format. So that will depend on the model. It can be one big text file or an R list or a number of input text files, whatever the model will read. The model folder is about running the model. The model will be coming from either a toolbox of commonly used models or any model can be used within this folder. The final step, output, is where we convert the model-specific output into more general text files, things like numbers at age or fishing mortalities, SSP and recruitment and so on. The final step then is to upload those results into the ICES databases, the stock assessment graphs and the tables and so forth. Behind each of those folders, data, input, model and output, there is an R script that governs what takes place. So let's take a look at those scripts in more detail. The first one is data.R. Again, that is where we pre-process the data and write out what we call TAF data tables. They're very simple cross-tab text files, comma-separated values. The next step is in input.R, where we convert those data to the model-specific format, writing out the model input files. In model.R, we run the analysis, often just invoking a shell command, or an R package to run the model, and the result will be results will be written out as output files. Those output files will often contain information about likelihoods or gradients and all sorts of extra information we don't really need. So we extract the results of interest in output.R, things like numbers at age and fishing mortalities, and we write them out as text files. Other scripts that we will be working with are report.R, which is an optional script where scientists can prepare any plots and tables that they are going to put in the report. And finally, there's upload.R, a very short script describing the data that are uploaded into the TAF system. So what we're going to be doing for the rest of the video is to go through the actual analysis behind the 2015 ICES advice for North Sea spotted ray. The R scripts can be found on GitHub. In the address you can see, ICES TAF 2015 RJM347D. And if you want to work along while you watch the video, you can download these from GitHub and work with them on your own computer. So let's just dive into data.R. At the top of the script, we have comments reminding us what is the purpose of the script, is to pre-process the data and to write out the TAF data tables. In the comment, we also write the state before the script is run and after the script is run in terms of the files and where they are. So we start with catch.csv and service-all.csv on the TAF database. And after the script is run, we will have catch.csv, summary.csv, survey.csv, all found in a new folder called data. We start by loading the ICES TAF package and create an empty directory. We next download the data, the catch and the survey, and we start pre-processing the data. We select the years of interest and the surveys of interest. We scale the surveys and create a combined index as the average of the three surveys. And this is the catch data. Very short history of of the catches for this fishery. And this is the survey data that we have selected the years and those three surveys. But importantly, we have also created a combined index, and that is the actual input data for the assessment. We finalize the tables and we write them out to the data directory. So what we have done is to create a data folder containing the data that will be used in the assessment, catch.csv, summary.csv, and survey.csv. In the catch.csv, we have the catch history. In the summary, we have combined the catch history with the index that is will be used, and the survey documents how the index is calculated. The next script that is run is input.R. It is a short script where we will convert the data to model format and write out the model input files. In other words, we will start with catch and survey in the data folder, but after the script is run, we will have input.R data in a folder called input. So we run those commands, again loading the ISIS TAF package, creating the directory. We simply fetch the catch and the survey data frames and save them together in one file, input.R data. The third script, model.R, runs the model, and the results will be written out as dls.txt inside the model folder. Now it's not enough just to have the ISIS TAF package. We also fetch a package called ISIS advice, containing the function that we'll be using to run the analysis, dls 3.2. So we start by creating an empty folder. We get the data from the previous step and we apply the DLS method 3.2. And the results are found in the model folder as dls.txt. It outlines the computations behind the advice. The advice is 291 tons, and it is coming from the last advice, 243, and some series of survey indices. And on average, they've been going up by 43%. And the DLS 3.2 rule is that we're not going to increase the advice by 43%, but rather by a maximum of 20%. So the advice is 291. The output.R script is about extracting those results of interest and writing out the TAF output tables. We're going to read in the dls.txt, and we're actually just going to copy it to the output folder. In more complicated stock assessments, this would of course take more steps, but here we just copy between model into output. Finally, in the report.R, we're going to prepare plots and tables that could be included in the stock assessment report, taking the summary from the data step, and we're just going to be plotting the survey as a PNG file. So we load the ISIS TAF package, we create an empty directory report, we read in the summary, and we create the plot, and we also write out the summary table, but this time rounding the catch and the index values to make it look better in a report. Inside the report folder, we now have summary.csv and survey.png. The survey looks simple enough, ready to be pasted into the report, and the summary rounds the indices so that they will look better in a report, maybe with three decimals or so. So you would just copy this into the report, essentially. In the R scripts, we've been using some commands that are outside of base R. We've been using some ISIS packages. So let's take a look at, for example, DLS 3.2. The help page describes it as a function to apply ISIS method 3.2, and it has some good guidelines and references on how to use that function. We've also been using some R functions from the ISIS TAF package. If we just take a look at the main help page for the ICS TAF package, it lists all the functions by sort of their groups. So some of them we've been using to read and write files. We've been using CP and mkdir to manipulate files. And we used TAF ping to open a ping graphics device to draw an image and write it as in ping format. Most of the ICS TAF functions are very short and simple, but they're simply there to make the scripts look more readable. They're convenient and sort of shorthand functions to get to the point without some boilerplate code that is needed. For example, in the report.R, we were using TAF ping like that, so it uses the sort of suggested image size and so forth. We also see in the help page some functions that we'll now take a look at to run the scripts. There are convenient functions for that as well. Source TAF is to run a single script, and source all is to run all of them. So let's take a look at how we can use those. Instead of running line by line like we were doing, we can start from scratch with nothing in here. And we can run them one by one, source TAF data.R. Very similar to the base R function to source. It adds some sort of helpful message with the time and what it's doing. But more importantly, we can run all of them, source all, and they run blazing fast. It's data.R, input.R, model.R, output.R, and report.R. And that is how assessments will be run on TAF once they're uploaded, is using source all. So what we have learned in this video is about the overall TAF workflow. And we used, as an example, the North Sea Spotted Ray as fully scripted analysis. We also have on the GitHub TAF page other examples that can be studied in the same way. That is Icelandic Haddock, North Sea Cod, and Eastern Channel Plaice. They are all age-based assessments. The Eastern Channel Plaice uses the FLR suite of our packages, and the North Sea Cod is a SAM model. The Icelandic Haddock is an AD model builder, age-based model. And we'll be adding more examples there as we go. In a future video, we will be covering the TAF web interface, where assessments can be browsed and run and modified, and how web services can be used to upload, download, and run models.